In this video, you're going to learn how to make one of these individual patchworks. This is part of a bigger project that will be at the Heinz History Center, and it is a very big quilt. This is only a part of it that you're seeing here, and you will learn how to make any one of these patches. Each of them has a phrase on it, an important, what I call a Bubby wisdom on it. Like this one says, closer to fine. This one says, plant seeds of kindness. And we will go over the technique for how to actually make one in this video. And then you will have the choice. You can just sit home and make one by yourself if you want, or you can make one and bring it into the History Center, or you can come to the makerspace at the History Center and make one there, or you can decide to be a stitcher. There will be volunteers who will be on site working with you and working with themselves to make all of these patchworks. And at the end of the exhibit, toward the end of the exhibit, we're going to take each of the patchworks and take it away from the piece and give them out to the general public. So even if you decide you're not a maker and you aren't really interested in making one for yourself, maybe you are interested in coming to see the exhibit and coming at the end so that you can have your very own patchworks to take home as a memory of our exhibit. We're going to go through the steps now of making one of these patchworks. So the first thing that you have to do is figure out what you want to say. And I have highlighted walk the talk. That's what I was thinking about. And so what I'm going to do is just take a piece of tracing paper and lay it over, and in pencil, I'm just going to outline walk the talk. And then I'm going to select a piece of fabric. And by the way, there's lots of statements, Bubby Wisdom statements. You can collect some of your own. You can follow some that are already on the quilt. Repeats are fine. And so now I'm going to look for a piece of fabric to put it on. And I just wanted to show you a couple pieces of fabrics. This is a remnant of patchwork that I did. And this is a scarf that someone I used. And this is a leftover. I think it'd be a great piece. This is my daughter's pants. I just hemmed her pants, and I'll cut this up, and this will probably make two different blocks that'll be fun. And this is a shirt with stars on it that I thought was really cool, and I've been using that in pieces. So there are all kinds of remnants that you can use to make it. So then you have your statement, you select your fabric, and you take it and you pin it onto the quilt. Pencil anymore, and just center it, and then we're going to embroider it with what in embroidery is called a back stitch. So you just pick a contrasting thread, something that you think will show. This is 6-strand embroidery thread with a knot at the end, and then you're going to take it and just follow the lines. You'll go. And you want to make the stitch is not too big. The stitch is maybe you'll be a quarter of an inch, a little bit more. And a back stitch as you come up at the next one. And then you go back to the beginning. And you can do that all the way along. I'm not going to take the time to do it here, but you can see that it's a back stitch that will someday soon say walk the talk. You can see that. And then I have one here that I did, and it was on the collar of that shirt, and it says of being. And again, this is the tissue paper. The writing was on there. You can see the back is kind of messy. You won't see the back when you're done. And then what you're going to do after you have it done and you like it and you like the way it goes, then you're going to take it and you're gonna rip off the paper. You don't need the paper anymore. And just take your time, and I hold the stitching while I'm doing that so it doesn't get messed up, the stitching. Even if it does get messed up a little bit, you can take a pin and pull it back underneath so it looks good. So then you'll have one that is finished. This is happy, is this one. And it's finished and the paper's off. And I pressed it just to flatten it out, make sure it's okay. And then you're gonna find an old piece of quilt or something to back it with. And these quilts are called cutters. They're quilts that just can't be used as quilts anymore because they're frayed. And so what you're gonna do is take the finished embroidery and put it onto, pin it onto a backing. And then we finish it with a buttonhole stitch. And how you do is you put the needle, the knot in, and bring your thread out to the edge. And then a buttonhole stitch is you go straight through, down, through all the layers, and you bring it underneath the thread, or on top of the thread, or you bring it through the thread. I don't know what the right term is there, so that you create this stitch. It's called a buttonhole stitch. It's a beautiful stitch. It's a beautiful finish. And you can do it all the way around. I always knotted it at each corner to keep it going. And then just finally, if you look here closely, you can see, let's look at this one, Fierce Mind. It has, you can see the buttonhole stitch going all the way around. And the final thing that we're doing for this project is that we are attaching it. We use this ribbon yarn to attach it with a slip stitch through onto the quilt, and that's so it can be removed later on when we disseminate the patches to all the people. That's how it will be done. We'll just take out this and we'll be able to take it away.